Hi everyone, it's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's our video tip of the day in our 30 Tips in 30 Days. I'm calling this tip, Keep It Simple. We're going to look at how you can customize your pages inside of Shotgun to make sure you're only receiving the information that you need. Now earlier, we had a video tip that focused on setting the permissions. Now permissions are generally going to be set up by an administrator. The administrator is going to set up the permissions for the different roles, different people that they're working with, as far as what they can access, what they can edit, what they can control, and what they can delete. But no matter what your role is, you do have control to change things at a project level. And everybody, no matter what their role is, can create their own custom pages and save those pages so they can organize their Shotgun site the way they want to. And that's what we're going to focus on in this tip. So here I'm logged into my Shotgun project and I am the admin right now. And we're looking at the shots page, but realize that any page that has columns and fields and so on, such as your asset page, your task page, and so on, the tips that I'm talking about right now are relevant to those pages also. We can see we have all these different columns and different fields and all these elements that are displayed right now. And this is the default setup that I've created as the admin. So everyone's going to see the same thing that I'm looking at. And there are many different ways that you can change what is displayed as far as what columns and fields and so on. But before I get into that, I just want to point out up here, you'll see this little page icon. This is the page settings flyout. And in here, you're going to see several different options relevant to the page that you're looking at. I want to point out a couple that are grayed out right now, the revert page and the save page. We're going to be coming back to this in just a minute. Let's start making some changes. Couple ways of doing it, as I said. I can go to the field menu, click on this, and you'll see all the different columns and fields that we can display, hide, or show. Notice also at the very top, there's the option called Configure Columns. I'm making a note of this only for the fact that I want you to realize you can access this option from many different places. I'm going to hide assets. You'll see there's a check next to it. We know assets are seen. We can see the column right here. I choose that. You'll see the asset column disappears. Notice that a little blue highlight or icon has appeared next to our page icon by the page settings. And if I hold my cursor over that area, it'll read this page has unsaved layout changes. Save the page to commit. If I click on the little arrow and I move my cursor so we can read everything, there's the save page and revert page. They're now available to us. We're not going to touch on them yet. I just wanted to point out that as soon as you make one change, any change whatsoever to the page, they become available. Remember, I am at the admin level, and that's going to come into play a little bit later, but just remember that, okay? Let's go back now, and if I right-click over any of these options, any of the columns, I come down to insert column, I get all the same options that I just did from when I clicked on the fields icon, including the top one that says configure columns. Let's turn on cut in. So now I've added the cut in column as one of my columns. If I come over to this little icon right here on the upper right, you'll see it's basically a little column, I guess, but it's got a plus sign next to it. I click on that. Again, I get exactly all the same options that we had a minute ago, either from the right click or from the fields. This time, let's click Configure Columns. And a dialog box opens that reads Manage Columns. You scroll down, you can see we've got some triangles that will let us access everything that we were able to access, again, from the other options. The main difference of using this, though, is we can hide and show multiple columns at one time, whereas the other flyouts, once you choose to show or hide something, that flyout disappears. So this is kind of convenient when you want to go and add and remove multiple things at once. So for example, let's say we want to add in cut order, I want to add in cut out. I'm going to scroll down and down here where we see it reads our pipelines. I've already got it expanded. I'm going to disable the FX option. So now we will not see the FX column, the FX task. Now I'll click apply, and the changes that I've just set up all took effect. Now let's go back to our page setting flyout, and let's discuss the two options I mentioned earlier, the save page and the revert page. If I choose save page, I am committing this layout to be the default layout for the shots page not just for myself, but everybody else that is working on this project. And when they go to the shots page in their shotgun login, this is what they will see as the default. I'm not going to click save right now. I want to discuss the revert page first before we save this page and any changes I made. The revert page allows me to revert this page back to where it was last time it was saved. So I can remove all the changes I just made and go back to the original layout when I first started this video. I'll choose revert page, and you'll notice the columns that were originally there are now back. The columns that I added are now gone. Also keep in mind, it's not just the fact that you show or hide a column that you'll have to save a page for, or you can create a saved page based on those adjustments. Just moving the columns around and reordering them, you'll notice as soon as I did that, the little blue icon appears again. I can now save this page or revert it. Let's make some further changes. So I'll go to my configure columns, and for demonstration purposes, let's add these columns once again. Let's go in and let's put task template. All right, that's good enough for right now. So I've made some changes. You also have a toggle all button. You can toggle everything on and off if you want. I'll choose apply, and my changes have been made. Let's move the cut duration right before layout. And I'll put the cut in over here also. And I'm going to now come and save this page. So I chose save. This is now the default layout and the default columns that are shown for everybody that's working with me on this project. Let's bring up another shotgun login as an artist to see exactly what the abilities the artist has as far as changing and altering the columns and so on, and how to create custom pages, which gives the artist the ability to alter and change that page themselves. So now we're looking at the same shot page, but we're logged in as an artist. And because of the permissions associated with the artist, they do not have the same ability to alter and change the default shot page or task page or any page that is a default page and save it. And just to show you the options we do have though, let me move some columns around. Let me also go and hide a column. We'll add a couple columns. We'll just make some changes. And again, just like the admin, when I made those changes, we see the blue highlight icon by our page settings. But if I expand the page settings, you'll notice save page is not available to me. I cannot save these changes to the default page for the shots. What I can do though is choose revert. That option will always allow an artist or anyone who doesn't have permissions to save a page layout to revert back to the original default layout created by their admin. I'm going to choose revert page, and then we'll see the layout and the columns will all go back to the original saved layout. So does this mean the artist can never create a custom page layout? No, it doesn't. They cannot alter this page, but they can create their own. What they can do is go to the page settings flyout and choose save page as. This will create a custom page just for them. It doesn't matter if you make adjustments or changes to the page before you choose the save page as option. You could come in and make those changes, or with the default layout still active, you can just choose the save page as option and you'll receive a dialog box asking you to name the new page you're about to create. So I'll name this shots-laura after the artist, and then I'm going to save this. Now you'll see the page is displayed with the new name up here, but it also reads private after the name of the page. So now an artist could come in, change the columns, change the order, change the fields, make any adjustments they want so this fits their need as to how they want to look at the shot information. And they will always be able to access this from the drop-down menus. You'll see it's listed now in the page flyout. Also, because it is their own custom page, any changes they make, they can save it inside of the page setting dialog box. All right, I'm going to remove the artist page, and we're going to go back to looking at my page, the administrator page, because I want to talk about some of the other options an administrator or someone who does have permissions to alter and change the fields and what those options are. especially with status. When working with statuses, there are a lot of different possibilities or options you can have available to your artist and the other people that are working with you. You might need a lot of them, but if you don't, simplifying them will obviously minimize the choices and simplify the workflow for the people that you're working with. Now, if I right-click on any one of the field names, you're going to see the option Configure Field. So as I go along, each one of them, you'll see it has that option. And depending upon the field, you're going to receive different options as to what you can and cannot change. Let's choose Sequence, I'll choose Configure Field, and you'll see a dialog box opens up and it shows me the different options as to what will be displayed. You have a couple options down below here. I'm just going to leave this one as it is and choose Cancel. If I right-click over any of the pipeline tasks, you're going to see the option called Manage Shot Pipeline. Choosing this option brings up its dialog box. Here I have the ability to control the visibility of the steps, the shot code of the steps, the color of the steps, and also I can delete a pipeline step if I wanted to. Also the order, I can grab this little icon and move it up and down to control the actual order as the pipeline steps will appear on the shots page. You can even add new steps. If I click the add new step option, I could enter a new step, I can enter the shot code, change its color, and so on. Let me just cancel that. I'll leave everything set to the default as it was right here and choose done. Now the status is another option that you have. So if I come over to where it reads status and I click on this, you'll see we've got all these different options here that are set up as possible status for the shot. Now maybe I feel these are too many. Maybe I don't want to have this many for my artist and the people working with me. So what we can do is right click over the status option and choose configure field. Now we get the configure field dialog box and we can come in and just like we saw with the pipeline steps, I can change the order, I can hide them, I can delete them, and I can add new ones. I can also control what is the default status for every shot when it's first added, the summary, and sort by options. Now if I don't want to delete the status, I can simply hide some of them. So let's say I hide view, I'll hide pending, and I'll hide confirmed. And I'll also hide omit. And then if I want to add one, I can just choose add new status. Now I have a list of all the possible statuses that I could add. Maybe I want to add on hold. So I check that. I choose next. It's going to ask me, do I want this to be on all active projects or only this current project? That's a decision you'll have to make based on your facility or your studio and how you want to work with the different statuses. I'll choose only this current project. I click OK, and then I'm going to click Update Field. Now I need to refresh my page for that new change to take effect, so I click the Refresh This Page button, and then I come back to my statuses, and you can see now I only see those possible ones I set to be visible. I didn't delete any of them. They're still available if I want to go back in and configure them, but now I have a much simpler choice as far as the status, which will simplify the options that my artist or whoever I'm working with will have available to them. And of course, keep in mind, everything that we just discussed and learned about controlling the columns and the fields on the shots page is relevant when you go to your asset page and you go to list view. All the same options are here. On your task page, you have the same options that are available there too. All right, so that's my tip for today in our 30 tips for 30 days.